far as with the specific rotator cuff muscles, the four different muscles in the shoulder that compromise the rotator cuff, we isolate each set of those muscles to work on a separate set of exercises here. One first exercise is working on your external rotators. This primarily isolates the muscles in the back, the infraspinatus, and the teres minor, and it allows you to get the external rotation. So what I like to do is I take these tension bands and I double them up. Okay? You grab your arm, keep your elbow at your hip here. Do not flail it out where it has to stay as you go. And then gently externally rotate, hold for a count of 10, and relax. Gently externally rotate, and relax. Okay? That works the posterior musculature. Okay? That being said, if you want to work the internal or the anterior musculature, so the subscapularis tendons up here in the front, and this allows and gives you the strength to pull inward. So the same thing, double up on your tension bands, and look straight ahead, and then internally rotate, hold for a count of 10, relax, hold for a count of 10, relax. That will balance out the front and the back of the shoulder musculature, okay? Next, as far as the supraspinatus is concerned, which is the tendon at the top, okay, which is the main tendon that people often tear, what I recommend is that oftentimes you'll step on the tension bands themselves and bring the bands up above your head. This is coming outward at about 45 degrees or so in front of your body, just gently in control, and that works out the supraspinatus tendon. For a count of 10, relax. For a count of 10, relax. Okay. So that will actually, right there, we've worked out basically every muscle that surrounds the rotator cuff. So that itself will help stabilize the shoulder, give you a stronger foundation for dealing with instability or inherent laxity or looseness in the joints. So, as I mentioned before, please check with your surgeon or your doctor. Plan to do these exercises to make sure they're okay for you, if they will work for you. Because if you do have any underlying shoulder pathology or any problems within the shoulder joint, you want to make sure that you're able to do these exercises without.